Hi, biology friends. It's Sarah, your other biology professor. Let's talk about ploidy. Ploidy is going to tell us something about how many sets of chromosomes are present in a particular cell. So how many different versions of each chromosome there are in that cell. Cells that have one copy of each chromosome are described as haploid. And in humans, these would be the gametes, the sperm and the egg. The haploid number, which we can abbreviate as N, tells you how many chromosomes are present within that set, how many unique chromosome types there are for that particular cell type. In this example, it's 5. So our haploid number, N, would be equal to 5. One each of 5 different chromosome types. Cells that have two complete sets of chromosomes, are described as diploid cells. The prefix di means two, so two copies of each chromosome. Not exact copies, but two versions of each chromosome. Now, in our example here, you can see that 2n, two copies of each of n chromosomes equals 10. Humans are diploid organisms. We inherit one set of chromosomes from the maternal side through the egg, another set of chromosomes paternally via the sperm. So in our somatic cells, our non-gamete cells of the body, humans have two complete sets of chromosomes typically. Now, in humans, the haploid number, N, is equal to 23. So how many chromosomes would be present in the somatic cells? 2N equals 46. Two copies, two versions, of each of 23 different chromosomes. 2 times 23, 46. A cell with 3 complete sets of chromosomes would be a triploid cell. The prefix tri means 3, so 3 sets of chromosomes. In our example here, 3n equals 15, 3 sets of 5 different chromosomes for a total of 15. Triploidy in humans is rare and it is fatal. Now, recalling that the haploid number n in humans is 23, how many chromosomes would you expect to find in a human cell with triploidy? 3n, 3 times 23, would be a total of 69 chromosomes. Instances where you have 3 or more sets of chromosomes in a cell can be described as polyploidy, poly meaning many. This is the result of chromosomes not separating properly during cell division. And plants tolerate polyploidy very well. It's quite common, not so much in animals aside from some groups of amphibians and fish. But in these cases, you can use that prefix as a clue as to how many chromosome sets you have in that particular organism or in that cell type. Some of the vocabulary can start to get a little bit overwhelming, but remember with ploidy, we're always referring to the number of chromosome sets in a particular cell. So drop me a like if you learned something about ploidy. Check out my website for even more resources, and I will see you next time. Bye.